Child Reviews Prince, and this is just a few final thoughts about the Hit and Run album. I've reviewed every track on this album, and if you want to see any of those videos, they're all available on my YouTube channel, so check them out. But this is just a few general thoughts about this album. The first thing I want to say is you should never really try and guess what Prince is going to do. Prince's albums, certainly in my experience, when you get them, are never what you expect. They're always something completely different. You never sort of have a handle on what Prince is going to do, and he always manages to surprise you, and I think this is no exception. I think one of the first things I'll say is this, to me, is a really fun album. This is not like Son of the Times or Rainbow Children with some, you know, a deep social or political or religious ideology. This is an album which is basically there to be enjoyed. This is an album to have fun with and just to party with. This is there's obviously ballads and other tracks, but it's kind of just a pleasurable experience, a really, you know, engaging experience. This certainly represents, I think, a kind of change of style for Prince. We started that change with the stunning Artificial Age and Joshua Welch becoming more involved and Prince moving towards a more electronic sound and kind of moving to a very more modern kind of futuristic kind of ideas about music. And I think this is really interesting because on one hand you've got this very modern, very upbeat, very sort of to the moment sound, but you've also got so many of the classic Prince elements. You've got, you know, the chicken grease guitar, you've got the screams, the guitar solos, the kind of catchy ballads that you can't get out of your head. And I think that's one of the great things about this, that Prince, whatever genre he visits, he brings his own Princeness to the party. The first four tracks to me are, you know, just pure party tracks. They are tracks which sort of set the scene, they set the experience. Talking about Million Dollar Show, Shut This Down, Like a Mac, Ain't About to Stop. These are songs to get you up, to get you partying. It's a club feel. This is kind of to make you move. You know, you don't have to think too deeply, just go with it and enjoy it and feel it. You then move on to the sort of new version of This Could Be Us, which is fascinating in the sense of how you can take a song and treat it in two completely different ways. First on the Artificial Age album, and then on Hit and Run, and how you can change it and morph it into a completely different sort of style and you know, sense of a song. And I really think that's fascinating because that really taps into how Prince deals with his songs and the choices he makes at the production stage and the choices that Joshua makes, and how you can take the original idea and it can go off into, you know, a number of different ways. I think, from my own personal opinion, Hard Rock Lover, A Thousand Hugs and Kisses, The X's Face, they stand up, I think, as Prince classics. They really do. I think they are songs that will be remembered for, you know, a long time to come. They really are Prince classics. They really are. You've got The Contemplative June, you've got Pop Perfection, I think, in Fall in Love Tonight, which is just, you can't get out of your head. You've got the kind of ambient, trippy, Ibiza-like Mr. Nelson. You've got so many things going on there. Those songs, I think, particularly at the moment, A Thousand Hugs and Kisses, it's getting a lot of radio play, and it's just such a catchy tune. I love the song to begin with, but I've actually grown to love it more and more and more. And I think it's really, really, really fascinating song. And I want to shout out to the UK Prince Army, who did a fantastic video of this, which Joshua Welton retweeted, which is just fantastic. It's kind of them sing along to A Thousand Hugs and Kisses. If you get a chance to see that, it's fantastic, really worth a look. But this is also a seeming return, I think, to Prince's prolificity. He, you know, phase two, potentially imminent. There's talks about the new album coming out, you know, very shortly, though you never know in Prince as well what's going to happen. But Prince sounds energised. He's trying, you know, an outside producer, which people have often said, you know, he should try, perhaps take on another producer. And I think it's obvious that he wants to work with someone he feels comfortable with. Prince can choose anybody, and I think it's really important that he works with someone he has a great working relationship with, and somebody who he can teach, you know, a lot of his skills to. And also, I've got to say, this is a massive responsibility for Joshua Welton, and he has done a fantastic job. I think, you know, for someone so young to come into, in my opinion, one of the greatest artists of all time, and to really, you know, have the confidence and to be, you know, to be brought along. I think Prince also doesn't get quite enough credit for working with other people and how he kind of adds to the party and how he brings the best out of those people. I read a quote once that said, you know, Prince can get you to do things that you never thought you were capable of, and I think that's so true. It's just an impressive part of him that doesn't get enough recognition. I also think that he's kind of comfortable for the first time in kind of giving away a bit of that control, letting someone else make some production decisions, letting someone else change his songs, and kind of, we're so used to seeing everything, you know, produced, arranged, composed by Prince. This is a chance for him to step back and let someone else move with that work, and I think that's a very brave and you know, an impressive thing to do. Ultimately, also, I think it's a very fast-paced album. I mean, I think this album, it's very fast-paced. It's full of technical gadgetry. It's full of sort of vocal effects, electronic tweaks. Obviously, as I mentioned, but with the Prince classic parts of, you know, Chicken Grease and the screams and that funky guitars. But it just roars out of the gate. It really does at a pace. It just kind of, it's out there. You've got these hypnotic hooks, like I said, like A Thousand Hugs and Kisses. You've got grungy funk guitar on the X's face. You've got signature Prince tunes, like Hard Rock Lover, which I think really is a classic. And Prince, you know, at the beginning welcomes us to the Million Dollar Show with a song that opens the album and really sets the scene. And I think that's kind of, you know, welcoming to the concert, come to the concert, this is the Million Dollar Show. And I think this sets up the album nicely. This is, you know, a concert experience. Get your energy levels up and enjoy this experience. I think it's, you know, a fantastic album. It's a fun album. It's a modern album. It's a brave album. It's a very different album to almost anything Prince has ever made. And I think to still be taking risks, to still be pushing things, you know, so far into his career, he's like, you know, well into the third decade of Prince's career. He's still challenging us and still, you know, producing music that's worth talking about, you know, discussing. And whether you love this album or whether you don't like this album, it has definitely energised the Prince community in the discussion of it. They really are talking about this album. They're really kind of conversing about this album, talking about what they like, what they don't like. I think it's really kind of, you know, pushed Prince, you know, to challenge people's ideas again, which is, you know, all part of the fun. I also think people are constantly talking about Prince's legacy and, you know, what his legacy will be. And I think, as I've said previously, that legacy to me is assured. I don't think there's a problem with that. But I really think this is a great opportunity by bringing in new artists like, you know, Rita Ora, Curly Fries, you know, bringing in Leanne LaHavas. By getting these artists involved with Prince, you know, some younger fans will get into Prince, hopefully, and then sort of, you know, listen to a few albums, then go back and explore the back catalogue. And, you know, whatever music you're into, you're going to find something in Prince's back catalogue that is just going to knock your socks off. So I think it's a fantastic chance to get a new generation in who say, oh, I quite like that song, or I listen to that song, or that song's, you know, fantastic, from Prince's Hit and Run or Artificial Age or whatever, and then go back and explore the huge back catalogue he's got. So I think by bringing in this new audience, new people will learn to appreciate his music. And I think the best way to ensure Prince's legacy really is to just bring in people of all different, you know, tastes in music. I think some Prince has always done, you know, whether it be a white audience, a black audience, whether it be funk, rock, pop. You know, Prince has always encapsulated all genres and all kind of, you know, strata of people. And I really think it's just, you know, another great chance for to bring in some new fans to appreciate Prince and kind of carry that kind of interest in Prince on. So, you know, go for it, why not? I also have to say, I don't like to reduce art to kind of a number, so I'm not going to mark my albums out of 10 or anything like that. What I'm going to do is leave it with a final paragraph as my kind of final statement on this album. And we're back in a few days. I'm going to be reviewing a Prince associated artist, and I'm going to be looking, you know, a very talented artist, and I will be looking at a couple of her albums, and you'll see who that is shortly in a couple of days. But until then, thank you. Thank you for listening. Thank you for your comments. Thank you for everybody's done, good comments, you know, bad comments, whatever. I just really appreciate everything. Thank you so much. And I'll see you just in a few days. Thank you.